Hey guys, Chris here from Art and Soul, here for your Tuesday tip along with Tyler's help. Thanks for stopping by as always. This Tuesday tip, I thought we would maybe highlight a painting that's going to be coming up here. We've endured a pretty mellow winter really, but at this period of the year, usually we all start thinking of the beach for some reason. Nothing wrong with the beach. So we got a painting coming up. Watch our schedule, it's going to be coming up, but this is the painting, Beach Willows, it's titled. And just kind of a neat beach scene, sunset, a lot of nice bright colors that we're all looking forward to seeing this time of year. Once the gray goes away, okay? So a lot of nice bright colors. And we're gonna walk through the painting of this today. And we'll have some fast motion through here, but we're gonna paint this whole thing today. I know in the past we've done paintings that were bits and pieces and in segments. Today, nonstop, painting one complete painting, Beach Willows, okay? So. That being said, I have our sketch already laid out. This is a 2-minute sketch to get this right. Nice big circle towards the left side of the painting, about a half inch in from the edge. This is a 10 by 20 canvas, by the way. About 4 or 5 inches down from the top, okay? That's where our sun goes, okay? The horizon then, 5.5 inches up, 5.5, 5.5 inches up from the bottom. Nice horizontal line, okay? And then just a rough sketch of what is the beach there, a little sand dune on the beach that the willows will grow out of and all that. Okay, our palette today is gonna be white, black, red, orange, 2 colors of yellow, one darker, one lighter, white and unbleached titanium white or off-white, okay? I'm gonna start out with the sky. I'll do all the blending for the sky. I'm gonna come back after the sky, paint this water in place. Okay, after I paint the water in place, I'll jump back up here and paint the sun itself, all right? After the sun, I'm gonna come down here and paint the dune down here with the willows, all right? And then just some of the highlights there at the end. This is how we start. Large brush, a little bit of water in the brush. I wanna start out nice and bright around that sun there, so I'm gonna go yellow, this bright yellow to begin with. Don't forget, acrylic paint's a medium. More paint you use, the better. All right, I'll see if I can stay outside the lines successfully. If not, it's not a big deal because I'm gonna come back and paint that first coat of that sun white anyway. White will cover it, plus we'll get a little bit of a glow going there, okay? So we'll get a lap or two around the sun. Nice bright yellow, a little bit of water in that brush. Don't forget your edges. Edges should match. Watch adjacent to them on the front. I'm now going to switch to the darker yellow. I'll paint it right next to that brighter yellow. And while these two colors are wet, they'll blend real nice. See how I have that real soft gradient where I go from, you can't really tell where the light yellow starts and the darker yellow begins. We want to blend those together. Gradient. Gradient is the term that we're looking for here. Nice gradient there, okay? I'm going to switch now to orange. Same process. A little bit of water. Not terribly concerned with my sketch right now. That sketch is just to help me get my head around where things are at. Clean my brush out, soften the edge. And I'm switching to red. All right, our sky's done, okay? A gradient from bright yellow, where the yellows cross over, darker yellow into the orange, orange into the red, end with pure red out on the edges, okay? A nice gradient, all right? So our sky's done, essentially done. I wanna come in here now, I'm gonna paint this water. We're gonna use the exact same colors, okay? Obviously, the sun's gonna be the brightest spot in the painting, so I want a little bit of that reflection to mirror out down here in the water. And if you look at the original real quick, you see where we're aiming, okay? I'll show you how to do that. I am, again, gonna start with the lighter colors, work light to dark, so bright yellow, and I switch to the medium-sized filbert. Again, my favorite brush, everybody knows that by now, right? Filbert. And these lines I want very horizontal. I want to keep these lines as horizontal as I can. If I let those lines wander off at an angle like that, water's going to run off the painting. You just have a puddle on the floor then. So keep these lines very horizontal, nice and flat. Lots of paint. At this stage, the more paint you can get on here for this water, the better. Okay? That's the bright yellow. I'm gonna do the same thing with the darker yellow. Switching to orange, not even rinsing my brush off. Maybe if I do this right, I can hide my pencil mark where I marked 5.5 inches. What do you think? You can see how I'm keeping the right side a little brighter. All right, I want underneath that sun to be pretty bright. I'll have a little bit of red and orange in there, but not much. Switching to red now. Same thing, gobs of paint. Horizontal lines. All right, I think I can live with that. I'm gonna switch now to our sun up here. I'm gonna start out with the same brush, clean brush, very little water in it, white paint. See how much paint I have in there? Lots of paint. And I just wanna cover this whole area with heavy white paint. White paint in acrylic is sort of a primer. So anywhere you might have a pencil mark or a stray brush stroke, white paint will cover it. I should have used white paint down here to cover my pencil line. I can still fix it. All right, I'm gonna switch to off-white. Still didn't clean my brush. I just wanna add a little bit of that here and there. And I'm gonna add just a touch of bright yellow. It is the sun, right? Little fix here. Okay, sun is done. Sky is done, water mostly done. I'll come back and embellish that in a little bit. I'm gonna work on this sand dune here that's in front. Again, same brush, black paint, okay? And all I wanna do, I wanna keep this a little bit wet. If you were to look close at the original, can you see all those streaks that are in there? It's supposed to look like grass, okay? You can see them, I'm hoping. So the way I'm gonna do that, when I apply this black paint, I'm gonna keep it a little bit wet. Then while that's wet, I'll show you how to do this, but I'll come back in with a smaller brush and I'll just show you how to do those strokes. So, wet black paint. Don't mind the phone, that's somebody signing up for a class, okay? You see how wet that is? It's running off of my canvas there, okay? Very wet. Okay, black wet paint, switching now to a liner brush, small liner brush. I really don't need to put any paint in it, all right? I'm just gonna pull up now from that wet black, short strokes, and these strokes probably aren't more than 1.5 inches long at the longest to start with. I just want grass here. And I'm gonna paint that kind of stroke all the way down to the bottom of this canvas. I'll pull some of that up in front of that water, but I'll also continue that stroke down below. See how that's beginning to look like grass there? This brush is loaded up with paint, so I want to keep it clean. I can only do a few inches at a time because I want to lift paint off of the canvas to achieve this grass look down here. Short strokes, kind of change the direction here and there. Don't make it look like your lawn. This isn't getting mowed. All right, I think our grass is done. I'm gonna switch now to the reeds or the cattails, I forget what they actually call these things, maybe pussy willows? But I'm not sure, but we're gonna paint those. So, same brush. A little bit of water in that black paint. I always tell people in my classes here that I want this paint to be more like ink than sticky acrylic paint. I do that by adding water, and I'll pull some of this off to the side until I can see through there. I want to see some transparency in this paint. In addition to that, I want to load that brush up all the way to the steel nib, okay? Some of these reeds will go clear up to the top of the painting, so I want to be able to paint in a single stroke that full length, okay? So I'll start down here at the bottom, and I'm just going to pull lightly, okay? In addition, you can kind of see how some of that color, those reds and yellows are shining through that. A little bit of a reflection there, but that is the stalk of our first willow here. And I'm just gonna fatten the end of that up for now. Same thing again. Some of these short, some of them long. But obviously, the further I move up here, the longer I want those to go, okay? you notice when I got up here towards the end, rather than come back and paint that shape in there, and I'll do another one and explain as I do it, but I'm painting fairly even pressure. I get up there till where I want this tip, where it broadens out there. When I get up there, I'll just start to press harder, and it'll automatically give me that wider tip that I'm looking for up there on the front. I'll do another one just to show you what I'm talking about. Give a little bit of thought at this point too, to have some of these cross one another, right? It won't look so contrived if you have them kind of blowing different directions in the wind. So let's say another one, we'll start right down here somewhere, and we'll have this one end up in this neighborhood here, okay? All right, so I'm nearing the end. I want to come back and straighten this one out a little bit, get a little fat spot here in the middle. All right, so right up here at the top, where I want that broadened tip to be, I'm just going to press a little harder, and then I'll let off on that pressure. See that? Automatically get that broadened tip that we're looking for. Simple, right? All right, so I think that's enough of those. There's one final highlight that we need to add. It'd be nice to have a little bit of glare from that sun shining onto those all those weeds there. So here and there, small liner brush and just white paint. You can put a little bit of yellow in there too, just kind of tint it a little bit. But it's mostly white, it's more white than yellow, okay? Same thing, load the brush all the way up, lots of paint, and I want to paint that little bit of a glare on the right-hand side of the head of each one of those little pussy willow things, and then a little bit down that edge there. Okay, so I'll start over here, just a real light touch. All right, guys, that's our painting in a nutshell. I may have done the total time on here in 15 or 20 minutes, maybe not even that, I'm not sure. But when we do this painting in a 2-hour class, clearly I'm able to spend a lot more time with it and do some a little bit nicer work on some of the details. The original painting that you see here, there's not a drastic difference in those two. But you can see what a little bit of extra time, taking your time, drying, maybe a little bit in between steps and all that. And again, this painting is coming up on our schedule. We're gonna tweak our schedule a little bit to see to it that it comes up a couple of times in the next 2 or 3 weeks. So watch our schedule, watch our Tuesday tips, look for our free giveaways, sign up for a class, come and hang out with us for a while. As always, thanks for stopping by.